You gotta control it, dude.
Alright, so what's up, everybody? It's your boy, AGN Kid Goggles, STR Kid Goggles. We out here chilling, rumbling the tundra like six. We're doing big things out here. This is Kid Goggles coming
losers,
up to you.
Losers finals.
These fresh losers finals. San iModerz. We really about to sit here and let this man, this like number seven on his own goddamn PR from Connecticut, come in here, invade our town, invade our state, invade our city, and just blow everybody the F up. But. Either way, no matter what happens, I'm going to give you that clean, smooth commentary. I'm chilling here with my boy, Lax the Rage King.
Lax the
Rage King.
Really, you're going to call me the Rage King?
After I done slammed my controller. I straight exploded.
It was like the
I slammed it the first time.
I thought you were just going to bite it.
I slammed it the first time, and I wasn't. I was not satisfied. I was not satisfied at all. So I straight slammed that. That joke exploded. Like,
I respect
that. That joke hit the ground and phased out of existence. I don't even know where the pieces went. I was like, and I immediately, because I had a new controller in the box waiting for it.
I already saw it.
And I felt so much better. I played a couple rounds already. I've been playing better.
It helps.
I'm feeling good. I'm like doing unique stuff. But anyway, we're not talking about me right now because I suck. I got fifth. I'm out the tournament. But we talk. I'm my face home. Well, anyways. So, we back here. AGN, STR San. They didn't get the STR part, but we're not talking about that yet. So, iModerz is taking the last two sets he's played versus San.
San won 3-1. And losers at Smash It Up.
Oh, you're right. You're right. So, they're 2-1 in iModerz's favor the last two sets they had. They played in winners this tournament, and it was a clean 3-0
clean
in favor. 3-0. Clean 3-0 in favor of iModerz. The reason that is because... iModerz, he's a 15-year-old phenom. He has been putting in mad work, and Fox is a very, very good character. San, or not San, but Ike. Ike is a solid character with nothing, like, too, unfortunately, like, overpowered about him. He just has really long range.
Right.
So, but the problem here is that Fox can kind of just run circles around him.
Yeah.
iModerz is basically just going to run around, do his best to absolutely never get hit, and anytime he sees San throwing an aerial on his way to the ground, he's going to punish it with dash attack. He's going to whiff punish it. He's doing it very consistently, and because Fox is so fast on the ground, just in the neutral ground game, he has the advantage because he can just fade in and out so quickly. It's a lot different than playing Sonic against Ike, because Sonic's speed is like, I can get from one end of the screen to the other end of the screen really, really fast.
Right.
Fox's speed is more like quickness. It's like I can be anywhere I need to be when I need to be there.
And it also helps he has that laser. So
yeah. So he can force Ike to approach. Gets with the up till up air. Very clean stuff. And also, it helps that all of his aerials auto-cancel or have a splash hitbox. Like, joint is ridiculous. Like,
yeah, Fox is a good
character. Like, the reason San beats a lot of people is because his aerials are so hard to punish. And Foxes are actually harder to punish because they all auto-cancel. San actually has to, like, space his stuff properly. Like, iModerz kind of just throws out back airs. He doesn't do up airs as much. Throws out back airs, throws out a lot of nairs. Full jump down air, because why? Like, look at that right there. Full jump down air, completely lagless, has a hitbox on the ground. Like, it's ridiculous. So... But San is doing a lot better this time of stuffing his approaches a little bit better, because the problem he's been having... So much damage. The problem San has been having is that he's kind of just relying on the way he beats everyone else, which is just kind of zone him out and kind of throw out hitboxes and hope people run into them, like I did a lot of times. But iModerz is very consistent about not getting hit, and he has the quickness to get in and punish with a dash attack that allows him to get a lot of damage. Like, I can, if I'm playing Sonic and I want to run in and punish him with dash attack, okay, cool, I got 6%, but what now? Nothing. Fox, look at that. Fox gets a dash attack. He gets a follow up or a combo or a setup to kill you at every percent.
He's designed for this, like this exact thing.
Gets a dash attack again. Wasn't in position to follow up on it. Oh, reads the roll. That wasn't a read. He reacted to the roll.
Wow.
Sometimes you're a little too fast for your own good there.
Yeah,
he actually did the
damage.
He did the short hop auto cancel back air. And then, phone not over here, bruh. I don't even got my phone on me, man.
That was actually a good game for iModerz. San just won. Because he's saying.
So anyway, we're going on to game two now. iModerz trying to take a stage with a little bit more stage for him to work with. He's very good at playing with his back to the wall. He intentionally runs to the ledge. He does not like being in the middle of the stage. He likes forcing people to approach him and then counterpunching. Like, basically, this is a match between two counterpunch characters, except that Fox can actually punch you. Like, Fox can actually be aggressive if he wants to, and Ike kind of can't. He kind of just has to solely rely on spacing his aerials properly.
I mean, I think he's taking about 15 damage off those lasers.
Yeah, like, he uses the lasers enough for it to be, like, statistically significant.
Yes.
Which is something you don't see from a lot of Fox players. They'll shoot one or two at the beginning of the game just to make you do something.
That's a good read.
Nice up smash. He punished it very cleanly. But yeah, they'll shoot off one or two lasers at the beginning of the game and then forget they have that move. Whereas I'm honest, he's doing enough damage with the lasers that if he was not shooting those lasers, that up smash he hit him with would not have killed.
Right.
Because he would have been at maybe 105 instead of 127. Mm. Ooh, gets the dash attack. Is that going to kill? Yes, it is.
That was a bad way to
very
for iModerz.
Yeah. That's the one thing Ike does have, especially with San, is that it's very hard to get away from him if you get put in a juggle position because his dash attack is basically a teleport. Like his dash attack is just like, yeah, look at like he's in one place and then he's in another place with a giant hitbox. Kills it like kills Fox around 90 or so.
Yeah.
So oh, nice down there.
Thanks. iModerz needs to relax a little bit. I think he's getting a little too aggressive right now. Just because he's
but
behind.
He's not falling into a lot of the air dodge baits, which is good. He's already doing better than me in that respect.
Yeah, pulling those shots back out. Nice.
Good oh, wow. Yep, get some of the side B. Ooh! Why can't you punish Fox's back air?
Now, what frame does Ike's back air come out?
7 is what San told me. Seems like it's way faster.
Yeah, no, it seems like frame 5 or something.
He used that junk like a Luigi Nair, like that junk is like frame 2 or something. And
good recovery.
The one thing Xander told me about Fox is that that's the reason he up B's into the stage the way he does. He'll up B into the stage at an angle and ride up the side of the stage because it snaps him to the ledge faster. Very
what happened
nice.
There? He didn't have a jump?
Yeah, he just didn't have a jump. But yeah. But yeah, Fox can like, if you ride the stage up, it'll latch to the ledge from farther below and thus make it hard to hit him out of the Firefox, which is why he did it there and he didn't get hit by the eruption, because the eruption is a big enough hitbox to hit most characters snapping onto the ledge, and he's very good at timing it, but when Fox rides up the stage like that and grabs it from lower, it makes him immune to those kinds of setups. It's a very crucial thing that Fox players should keep in mind, because recovery is one of his weaker aspects.
Definitely.
So you need to know and understand all the options you have at all times. So it's 1-1 now. And San still just throwing out shield grabs, knowing, like, you have to know at this point that he's going to, there you go, that he's going to get behind you with that down air. I have to feel like he got that from me. Got that down air from my Kirby. Like, yeah. Like, I done messed him up with Kirby's down air so many times. Uh-oh, he's dead.
Oh, San is just... His fingers are sick today. I guess iModerz at least. Good down tilt.
Yo, you know how much trash this set makes me feel like? Like, if I could beat San... If I beat San, I feel like I'm winning the tournament. Like, never lost to iModerz. Clearly was... Oh, man. I shouldn't have lost to Ling Ling. Like, I was... Anyway, we're not talking about me right now. I'm going to try really hard to not talk about me. Because I'm not important right now. I'm just fifth place. I suck. I'm not important. Wow, what is he swinging at off stage like that? Yeah. Fox wasn't even close to that. Almost got himself killed. It looks like he's, like, just, like... It feels like he's just trying to do tech demonstrations just to, like, get himself back into the rhythm of the game. Like, he forgot how to play for a minute. And I lost to this. That's what made me mad. Anyway. Up throw.
Four.
Yeah. Nice DI, though.
Good DI.
I think, I'm pretty sure you want to, you can DI Ike's up throw to either side to make it a little bit harder for him to hit you with that forward air. But when the forward air hits you at kill percents, you want to actually DI down and away the majority of the time, because if you DI to the side or DI up, you'll die off the top way, way earlier.
Yeah. Ooh, good back air. I actually kind of wanted to see iModerz use his gun a little more on that stock, but I mean, he's back now and he's using it, so.
It's the up throw, yep. No follow-ups.
Good in butter.
Walks right into the back air. Oh, he could have dash attacked that, but a little bit scared. A little bit too close for comfort. Down until fair.
Sand spacing pretty well
right
now.
Get these B&Bs out. I feel like if he didn't hit the balloon right there and get stalled, that he would have hit that nair on the two-frame get-up.
Sam is doing a better job of spacing right now.
Yeah.
I'm not just kind of running into it.
He's playing the mid-range game much better. Wow. Still again.
Wow.
Like, look at that. Why?
Wow.
Why? Why did that work? Wow. Why did that happen? Why did any of that?
That back air. Because he was dead if he got that up air off. Fox.
Yeah.
That was nice. That's that frame three back air that you were talking about.
And there's a hitbox everywhere.
Apparently, because he was definitely
that
below
that junk hits him in front of him, behind him, above, below. It's everywhere. Why?
All right, so what is this game for?
Yep. San up 2-1. He probably shouldn't be, considering he killed himself right at the beginning of game three.
Oh, yeah. Oh,
he did bring it back.
iModerz has to win those games if San is SDing.
So many hits. It's so hard to tell when you can drop shield.
Just never. You're playing Fox. Never drop shield.
Yeah, so I think what San did much more effectively in game three was that he was playing the mid-range game, holding down the middle of the screen and not throwing out as many attacks. And what that allowed him to do is that allowed him to put the perceived pressure.
Yeah.
He didn't actually have to do anything, but the fact that he made iModerz realize that he couldn't shoot lasers because he was at a percent or at a range where he could get punished if he tried, that got him a lot of ground.
Yeah. Just so many jumps from iModerz.
Well, it's not like he can run anywhere on the ground. Oh, he shouldn't have gone for that. It's not like he can run anywhere on the ground because he's always got his back to the edge of the stage.
Yeah.
So the only thing he can do is jump most of the time.
Just so many.
Wow, jab just in time to stuff that grab.
That frame two jab. Go back air.
He did. Is he going to make it back? No, he is not. Back air with that mean angle. Usually San can DI things up to get enough time to charge his side B, but Fox backer just sends you straight horizontal, so it's much harder to get that charge in.
He missed that punish. He knew he was going to side B. Just
wow!
That time.
He was confident in that up smash.
Almost a full stock ahead.
Oh, this kid's definitely going to have to money match me tonight.
Maybe you can get down stream too.
Up till forward air.
He's a full stock ahead.
Oh, finally. In there? Yep. Oh, I thought he was going to whip out with the up smash right there.
Ooh.
Ooh, jumps over the back air. Wish I could do that.
Just more.
Oh, caught him jumping out of shield. Stuffed it with a dash attack.
Is that up till?
Jumped.
Wow.
Oh, I thought that was the second stock. I don't know what I was thinking.
No, I like it. Stay patient.
Yep. Don't go for it. Uh-oh. Damage incoming. Uh-oh. No. Oh.
He got there. Wow.
I didn't think he was going to have the time to get there, so I didn't think he was going to pull the trigger.
Yeah, I didn't think he was either.
But iModerz clearly knows Fox better than I do.
Now, could San have air dodge there?
If he didn't, he couldn't.
Okay. Okay. Maybe I was just thinking maybe he didn't think Fox would get there either, that he would try.
Oh, no.
He was like, jamming
you,
it. Yeah.
Like, even if you don't think he's going to pull, you still got to jump away. Yeah, you're still going to jump away or air dodge.
Right.
So, like.
Yeah, he definitely couldn't have that. Wow, I can't believe Fox got there.
I can't believe Peach about to win this tournament. That's what I can't believe. This is some garbage right now. I done failed you all. I am so sorry.
It's still game
five. I could have stopped this. I could have kept this from happening.
You could have, actually.
It's all my fault. But it's all good. Man, if I had known If I had known obliterating my controller would have made me play as much better as I've been, I would have did that junk like after the first round of this tournament.
Just don't
like,
smash your controllers continuously.
No. I only did it because I knew I had one in the back. I knew I had one. I literally crushed the controller. Like, it was like a combo. It was like controller crush to unbox combo. Because I immediately walked over, grabbed my new box, and just pulled out the next controller.
It's a new box combo. Wait, what stage? Oh, okay.
Battlefield.
Great stage for both of these characters.
Ooh.
I don't actually know how I feel about this because, like, Ike's power on this stage comes from the fact that if he hits you on the platforms, he can cover you very easily and he can kill you a lot. He can kill you at normal percents regardless of the fact that how big the stage is, but iModerz gets really good platform combos.
Like that.
So, like, I don't know if it's a good idea to go here because that's what Fox can do on this stage. So it's like, it's a really good stage for both characters, but it feels like a better stage for Fox right now. How's he at 86 already? I saw him hit like 3 up airs, and he's already at 100.
Oh my gosh.
That was really slick, by the way. Like, somehow he got reverse hit double jab into up tilt back air. Like, that was some very solid presence of mind by iModerz.
Yeah, San has to switch something up right now.
Ooh, it's nice mix up.
Not working.
Usually, iModerz will land behind you with the down air and try and up tilt you, but that time he four tilted instead, which kind of, I think, threw San off. He didn't come out of shield. Side B, up air, true combo.
Sam's
need
in
to,
trouble.
Like, y'all, now I see what it's like when, like, people fight Pikachu. Because, like, if you let Pikachu hit you with quick attack, then, like, you're going to have a bad time.
Right.
And if you let Fox hit you with this side B, it's not a good look for you. Like, even if you don't punish it, it's dangerous enough that you need to just hold shield and make sure you don't get hit by one too many up tilts there by iModerz. Wow, he just let him come down with an attack. Certain characters are, like, really awkward to ledge trump properly. Fox, he goes very high and very shallow with his getting trumped animation. So sometimes if you just drop down double jump back air, it won't reach him because he's too high up. Uh-oh.
Good to know.
Side BT stage, yeah, that was very easy to read. That was extremely obvious. So it's 2-2. Last stock. We got a last stock situation.
Sam can definitely hold his back.
It's only going to take one down tilt.
And that gun. He's forcing Sam to approach.
Come to me! Yep, keeping it consistent. Not trying to do anything crazy. Saw him tech in place.
Yep, more gun.
Yo, man. Old friend of mine from back in the Melee days, back in like 2005, 2006, told me something very important that I'll never forget.
What was that?
He was an extremely campy Fox and Falco player, and when we asked him why, he was like, yo, man, I got infinite bullets. Why would I not shoot them all? And that, like, that's one of those simple things that just kind of stick with you. Like, yo, he really does have infinite bullets, though. He only needs about probably like 10 more percent.
For that confirmed.
Probably one more dash attack, and that he'll be in. Uh-oh, that might be it.
Mm. All right, well, he's definitely in range for it now.
Yeah, he wanted it too bad. Oh, wow, four tilt out of the down air again, and then jabbed immediately afterwards. Wow, he is just pumping out so many hitboxes.
Wow.
And he
that
takes it.
Was convincing.
I don't know, he takes it.
Yo, you ain't trying to money match me, though.